My youngest son, Aiden, had a difficult start to life. By age two, he was hurting himself because he couldn't communicate very well. Out of frustration, he would hit his head on the wall, the floor, or whatever else was around. Neither my husband James nor I had any idea how to help him. The pediatrician referred us to a speech therapist who taught us basic sign language. This was our lifeline until Aiden was able to conquer his speech. An occupational therapist worked on his sensory issues. Every trip to the grocery store, every haircut, every time we dressed him was an assault on his senses. We soon learned Aiden was on the autism spectrum. Autism required everything that we had. At the lowest point, we both quit work to be home to tag team this powerful foe that held our sweet social butterfly captive. This boy who loves people, who makes friends easily, and has more personality than anyone I've ever met was being paralyzed by social anxiety on top of everything else. Yet his heart desired the social connections. It was hard to watch, and I remember thinking it was so unfair. We didn't have the resources to get things that could make his life easier. It was time for a change. So I started online classes at the community college. This was my way of being able to stay home with Aiden, but also with Gracie, Matthew, and Austin, who still needed a mom that had something left to give them. Shortly after I enrolled in school, so did my husband. Now we were both online students. My oldest son, Austin, even gave college a try after he got his GED. This year, Matthew, at 16, began the Running Start program at Clark College, giving him the opportunity to possibly graduate with a high school diploma and an AA at the same time. Grace and Aiden both began K-12, an online public school they do from home. And while they enjoy the educational flexibility, they just mostly love doing school in their PJs. I graduate this spring and am considering a low residency MFA in creative writing at Goddard, which, I'll admit, sounds nuts with a family this busy. The point of sharing all of this is to show you not everything has to follow the same well-traveled path that everyone else is on. Sometimes you have to do things a little differently, which maybe means going back to school after being away 15 years because life got a little messy. So whatever insanity or hardship you are facing, someone has already been through it. Reach out and find others who will understand. The bottom line is, your story is important. You are important. Make mistakes, get messy, figure out what works by trial and error, but don't be afraid to live your life. On the flip side, be kind to your fellow humans. We could all be a little nicer to those around us. We can't always know what someone else is going through, and many of us are good at hiding the hurt. I challenge all of you to step out of your comfort zone, find out more about the people around you, ask questions, get involved, lend an ear. Just be kind, but be kind to yourself too.